Welcome back to another video of Activerse Universe. Today is a new day, hey, and we got a what? We got a banger! Let's go! Alright guys, today I'm gonna be giving you guys three tips of do's and don'ts when it comes to your hair growth. It's crazy because I've been getting like an inch of hair growth a month since I started my undercut process, which is in the back of my hair. And the reason I started the undercut process is because I want a mohawk dreadlocks. And so a lot of you guys have been suggesting me that I cut off some of this hair to attach to the back of my neck. And I've thought about that. And the other thing that I thought about also is adding a dreadlock extension. But before we get even into the details of it, I just want to say thank you guys for Pineapple World. We almost at 200 Facebook group followers and over like I would say 50 to 60, 70, even 100 shares of your guys' journey on the Pineapple Facebook groups. And for those of you guys that don't know about it, now you know, just go down to the link description, you find it. And also we have a YouTube page for that. And the YouTube page is doing really great too, because you guys have been showing love. So thank you guys so much. So without further ado, let's just get into the video. But I wanted to say this, I'm gonna be dyeing my hair soon, guys. So don't get mad at me if I pop out with a new hair out of nowhere. I know I asked you guys to get my Instagram page to 10K for the next dye. And I'll appreciate if you guys do that, but I still would do this just cause the time that is coming. And I'm planning something for my hair. The other announcement that I want to make is that a lot of you guys have been requesting dreadlock jewelries, and please comment down below if you guys are still interested in that so that I know I should be working on it. You know what I mean? I know that I'm bringing it out, but I want to know. Alright, growing your hair is it seems sometimes hard, it seems sometimes like uncomprehendable, but it's very easy to grow your hair pretty good and healthy. First, you gotta know what your hair type is. Is it just one? Is it in the twos, 2A, 2B, 2C? Is it in the threes, 3A, 3B, or 3C? And then 4A, 4B, and 4C. I know that some of you guys do have a challenge. No matter what number or category that your hair type is, you still have a challenge growing your hair out. And that is because sometimes genetics is just made that way. And so it's hard for you to grow hair out because your hair genetics may not be as great as the next person. I don't know if you guys noticed, but some people are really hairy. Some people are not hairy at all. There's some people in between. So that all depends on, you know, what your genetics is. And it doesn't really matter where you're from, because there's people that can grow hair like crazy from India. There's people that can go crazy hair from China and all the way to Africa, all the way to America. You know what I mean? So don't think about your racial type or who you are as a race, but look at it from your personal experience. How has your hair been growing while you were growing? You know what I mean? Don't just jump to conclusions saying that there's ways to make your hair grow faster because you put, like, you know, you drink enough water and stuff like that. Those are things that can help you get there. For example, my hair, I've noticed it grows an inch a month. I would say compared to everybody that's watching this video right now, I'm the least person to drink water. I drink a lot of lemonade, sometimes a lot of water too. Depends on what day it is, especially if it gets hot. But I'm not the type of person that has a routine even on water. The only times that I only have a routine on water is in the morning time when I wake up. I do drink some water. I wouldn't say enough water, but I drink some water. And maybe that contributes to it. But to come down to the science, it is just genetics that matters. That's the first thing. The second thing you can actually do to help out grow your hair is not touching it too much. Don't touch it too much. Don't put too much chemical. Don't put too much chemical in it. Don't try to wash it every single day. Like, don't do a lot of stuff that will end up preventing and even damaging your hair versus helping your hair grow. A lot of people have like a lot of routines that they do daily. You know, they wake up, they take a shower, they wash their hair, they put soap in their hair, just scratch the top of their scalp, just to get some routine going on, thinking that that's gonna make their hair grow faster, but it doesn't. Those things that you should apply for your hair routine and different things is to make sure your hair is good, it's not tangled up or it's not breaking apart. Those are the things that you should do on a morning and night basis if you have a routine. For example, I do not have a night routine. I promise you, I just knock out in bed, like literally jump to bed, sometimes on my phone, which I'm starting to quit using my phone before I go to bed, but that's it. That's my right night routine. My night routine is that. Okay? So don't let anybody else fool y'all by telling y'all, oh, this is my night routine. Is it though? Are you doing that every day though? Once a week maybe? Let's be honest, you know? And going to the morning routine also, yeah, that. But if I were to have morning routine and night routine, I would definitely put my hair in a bonnet or something like that, just to get it all together so it doesn't flap and flip-flop everywhere in my bed, so my bed don't get, like, you know, small pieces of hairs and different things. And then in the morning time, I would actually drink water, because drinking water in the morning time is really good for you and healthy for you in general. It doesn't have to be specifically for your hair, it's in general good. The third best way you can actually allow your hair to grow is by actually putting in the protective styles like braids, two-strand twists, cornrows, and not too tight. You know, don't put your hair in a hairstyle and tighten it too tight, man. That's not good for your hair. But I'm talking about some hairstyles that's not too tight, but enough to hold it all together so that it can grow at its normal pace. You know, there's no faster pace, there's no lower pace. I think there could be. The only way you can consider a lower pace and a faster pace growth is when you're not doing what you're supposed to do. When you're not doing what you're supposed to, then of course it will lower down a little bit, you know, your growth rate or the amount of benefits that you can give to your hair. And of course, if you do what you're supposed to do, like, you know, not washing it all the time, not doing a lot of stuff with your hair all the time, but letting it actually grow itself out, those are the times that I would say there's a lower pace and a higher pace. But in general speaking, ultimately there's only one pace, and that is your pace, your hair, how it grows genetically. But the third way, of course, you can benefit breakage from happening, a little bit of more growth, because now you're doing something with your hair, is of course to put in the protective hairstyles, which a lot of people do recommend, two-strand twists, you know, braids and stuff like that. My favorite one that's not too tight on your hair is braid and or two-strand twists, because all you're doing, especially with two-strand twists, is twisting them together, holding each other accountable so that it can just grow at its own pace. For my hair undergrowth that I'm growing right now, I've been getting an inch a month, and this crazy thing is I do not have any protective hairstyles. I am not, you know, washing it every day. I'm not applying any chemicals, any oil in my hair every day, and yet I still get that growth. And one of the things I notice about my hair is that it produces a lot of oil in itself. That has helped me with my growth, but I would say it causes a lot of dandruff to happen in my hair too, because mass oil production will end up having a mass buildup in your hair, or dandruff. Sometimes it's not really a dry skin that you're facing, it's the dryness of the oil and stuff like that that came out your hair, causing your hair to have dandruff. So for those of you guys that lack a lot of oil in your hair, of course apply oil so that it can have less friction in your hair and less breakage in your hair, so your hair can actually have its integrity, and also you will have basically a bunch of hair that will growing together. It's always good when your hairs are growing together, when you're having to do with the hairstyles, for example. It just holds each other accountable from going anywhere else, versus, you know, you just don't do nothing to it, you know, you just sleeping, waking up, then it can cause problems. Once my undercut comes to a length to where I can have hairstyles with it, I will definitely start giving it a hairstyle. Right now, it's not that long. It is only about 2 inch, maybe 2.5 now, but at the end of this month, I'll update you guys on my 3 months, and if it actually grew an inch a month, which it should be 3 inches this month. If it's not, then it probably started to grow faster and to slow down because of some reasons that I need to look at and recalibrate and comb back to my hair. But even my dreadlock, this is almost 2 years to almost three years this December. So I've been having my dreadlock for 3 years, and this is how long it is. Show me anybody that has dreadlocks with 3 years of growth up to this length. I didn't just start off dreadlocks at this length that you guys are seeing right here. But at the same time, like, I trimmed it twice recently, once because the ends were really breaking up, you know, the breakage that you get at the ends. I just decided to cut it, but I could have, you know, blunt the tip to prevent myself from cutting it, but I just wanted to cut it and kind of be done with that. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and these are some great tips that you guys can apply. Don't let anybody fool you telling you that, you know, you can grow an inch a month by buying this product. You know what I mean? That's not true. Thank you guys for watching this video. What are some things that you guys have done to help your hair grow, or mistakes that you guys have made to prevent it from growing? List it in the comment below. Thank you guys for watching this video. But till next time, keep acting diverse and creating your universe. I'm Activerse, and I'm out. Peace out. Stay tuned. God bless.